A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. I want to share with you some reflection on the hadith in which Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught Hazrat Aisha radhiyallahu ta'ala anha what to ask, what dua you should make if you can find Laylatul Qadr. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. Ya Rabbul Alameen, you forgive the most and you love to forgive. I ask you to forgive me. This dua actually tells us that what should be our priority number one if we can find Laylatul Qadr is to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, pardon. This should be the priority number one, my brothers and my sisters. You know, in this dua, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not use the word Allahumma innaka ghafoor. Maghfira, like, is something you cover. But covering your mistake does not guarantee that there will be no accountability on the day of judgment. You know, maghfar we say to the helmet people use in battleground to cover their head. So Prophet here did not use Allahumma innaka ghafoor. Rather, he used Allahumma innaka afuun. In afuun, what is included that not only Ya Rabbul Alameen, you forgive, and also I am requesting you to remove, to wipe them out, to wipe them away, all my sins, to make my record clean like there was no sin. All my sins, all my shortcomings, all my deficiencies. This is the request. This is the dua you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, we can ask other duas as well. In Ramadan, our spiritual status, our iman, our emotional status, our sincerity is in best of the position in Ramadan. So chances of us having more closer relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are very high in Ramadan. So the chances of acceptance of our dua are very high. For this dua, I would like to request you, before you raise your hand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I have two requests. Number one request is, as in Surah Taghabun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says when he is talking about, you know, how you deal with your family if there are issues, وَإِن تَعْفُوا وَتَصْفَهُوا وَتَغْفِرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. That you forgive them, you overlook their mistakes, and you cover up their mistakes and their faults. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah is Ghafoor and Rahim. And you expect from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He should forgive, He should overlook, and He should cover up your mistakes. The same Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking you. That's how you should behave and handle when it comes to your family. If you are expecting that from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to forgive, to overlook, and to cover up your mistakes, that Allah is asking you that you should also do the same with your family. So the first request I have, that for a reason or without a reason, if any of your family member, your friends, the people you know, if you have any friction, if you have any issue with them, forgive them, call them, make dua for them in their absence. So then your chances of acceptance of your dua will be very high. The second request I have, to try to find seclusion, privacy, that you can be alone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody else is watching you. Because when we are alone, our emotions and our feelings, our heart and our tongue, they all can come together easily. When you are among people, it's very difficult to bring your emotions to the level so that you can have best of the connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because dua is not about words. Dua is a sound coming from my heart, my brothers and my sisters. So it's very important that for this dua, that find seclusion, some privacy. Make this dua in sujood. Make this dua by raising hands in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with humility, ajizi, inkisari, like a beggar. Because that is the station that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes the most. Forgive everybody before you raise your hands and find a seclusion place, find some privacy, so to raise hands in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, give us tawfiq.